proudly brought to you by HoverTech. HoverTech, just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to flash a Mediatek Android phone firmware using NCK Pro Box Android MTK module. First off, you need to have the hardware box and need to have set it up. We have a guide for that. You also need to have installed your Mediatek USB VCOM drivers. We have a guide for that also. You need to have the firmware which you intend to flash, whether SCATA or bin format. For this tutorial, I'm going to be flashing a SCATA format. You also need to have downloaded the NCK Box MTK module and installed it. And of course, you need to have the Android phone, the MTK phone which you intend to flash. Now, once you have all this in place, the next thing you want to do is to run this module as administrator. The reason why you're running as administrator is because you are very likely to run into permission issues during backup or flash. So it's best to just run as administrator so you don't have to repeat the process all over. So I'm waiting for the dashboard to come up. Alright, awesome. I have the dashboard up. Now, for flashing, you have two options. You can flash in SCATA format under the main tab, or you can flash in bin format under this tab. I'm flashing in SCATA format, so I will just come right here. Now, under the phone setting, what you want to do is to leave this first option as 0 by CPU, and then for the second drop down, select your phone's chipset. If you don't know how to find out your phone's chipset, we have a guide on how to do that, so make sure you see the guide. Mine is 6580, so I'll select that from this drop down. Now, heading over to the flash scenario, you can select what flash options you want. For this guide, I'm not doing anything out of the ordinary, so I think I'll just go with the safe flash, nothing mega. And under here, you can decide to tick on tick reboot after flash. I will just leave the default options. Now, the next thing you want to do is under your firmware settings, you can decide to enable version check, checksum, and other stuff. But you can just leave all those unchecked. They are quite optional for you at this point. Now, what you want to do next is to load your firmware, which is by selecting the SCATA file. So you click on open SCAT file. Now, in this window that pops up, what you want to navigate to the location where you have your firmware. Mine is here, and you select the SCATA file and then you click open. Alright, so phone details are displayed as you have here. So now it's time to flash. So what you want to do is to click on flash firmware and then you click open. Alright, great. When you see please insert USB cable now, what you want to do is to power off the device still with battery in it. Don't hold any button. Then you connect it to the box via the USB cord. Forgot to power off mine. So I'm powering it off right now. It's very important to remember that the box goes into your PC and then your phone goes into the box. That's how it's connected. So I'm powering off my phone. Okay, it's powered off now. Now I'm going to connect. Alright, great. So I have detection. So flashing has begun already, and okay, still loading the preloader. It's important you do not interrupt flashing process, because if you do, it could cause your phone to go totally dead, in which case you either have to take out and reinsert the battery or you keep charging till it comes up. So I'm flashing. Do not interrupt the process. Okay, it's going to take a while because I'm flashing system. Yes, this is the very reason why it's going to take a while to flash 1.8 gig. So it's going to take a while to flash, so it's very important you be patient, do not interrupt the process and just sit back. Okay. Percent after quite a while, almost done. Just need to keep. Okay, 99%. Very important, you do not interrupt the process. Alright, so that's done. So you can power off the phone after disconnecting now. So that's basically how to flash a Mediatek Android phone's firmware using NCK box Android MTK module.